Ed, I think it's safe to say that the Bank of Canada has ended its rate hike cycle. There is a school of thought that the central bank will start cutting rates by mid-year. Your thoughts?
I do. I think just given the signaling the bank has done, they will not go at the next meeting, but the meeting after that, June, I think is live, and any meeting after that is live. And I think that given the weakness in our economy, I hope they're not tepid. I hope they start to move and move aggressively because I think I think we're going to slow down pretty hard.
Let's talk about the pace and by how much. There's this idea that the bank will cut rates anywhere in the neighborhood of 100 to 150 basis points over the course of the year.
Well, again, we'll have to see the data. And I think what's going on right now is the central bank, let's give them their due. It was a very difficult cycle, a pandemic lockdown and a post-pandemic recovery. So they were very surprised by the shock up in inflation. It looks like it, with the benefit of hindsight, is probably is transitory. I think they want to make sure that, the inflation expectations are well anchored in their target range. And we're still probably, kind of ballpark another 50 to 100 basis points of inflation coming down before they really will feel comfortable. I think if we get that, then they move aggressively. And that would be my recommendation for that. So I think their fear, of course, is a stagflation where inflation stays up, the economy slows. That is, and in that case, all aggressive rate cuts will be off the table. But I think that we're going to slow. Inflation should come down, but it's very tricky at this point because, again, the nature of the post-pandemic recovery. And when they move, I think you talked about 100, 150 basis points this year. I think that seems about right. The market's pricing 85 the last time I checked. I think we could see 150. I wouldn't shock me if we see 200.
When you take a look at the recent CPI numbers coming out of the US, which came in a bit above expectation, does that change the course of what the Federal Reserve is going to do? And does the Bank of Canada wait to see what the Fed does? We know that it's been a tale of two economies. Does the BOC wait to see the Fed's first move?
Well, they're very data dependent at this point. They're kind of at a pivot point, if you will. So the higher CPI down there, not by a lot, by a smidge, again, maybe pushes them off, a meeting, and then they'll reevaluate. And what's priced into the U.S. is almost exactly the same as Canada, about 85 basis points this year. They are starting from a higher policy rate of 5.5%, though, and their economy is stronger than ours. So it's less interest rate sensitive. The consumer's been hanging in there well. Obviously, the markets are doing quite well, so there's a wealth effect going on, I think, as well. So it's not inconceivable that. The Fed gets delayed. And then the problem the Fed has, and they always say they're apolitical, but they're not sensitive to the political cycle. And we're heading into the November elections, right? So that becomes a bit more tricky for them in terms of changing monetary policy. But I think that the Bank of Canada will move without the Fed if we need it. I think it's easier for the bank to move with the Fed, but they'll move without it for sure.
Depending on who you talk to, we're either in a recession or headed for a soft landing. How do you see this?
I think if you'd asked me a year ago, the probability of hitting a soft landing, I'd have said less than 10%. Very, very difficult. You have to assign a higher probability to that, I think, for sure. So when I, as an investor, I always think of, what's the probability distributions, right? So I think soft landing is now up from 10% to maybe 25 or something like that. There's still a stagflationary risk we have that we talked about earlier. I don't think that's a high probability, but you throw kind of a 10% or so probability. I think over 50% baseline, I think, is a recession. And it's just a matter of, that's why I really would like the Bank of Canada, once they come around to that, to start acting decisively and moving, in 50 and potentially more basis points at a time, as they did on the way up, because inflation is on its way down. I personally, 2 or 3 years out, still worry about deflation, disinflation, and getting stuck back at a policy rate of zero, and getting back there with an even bigger debt stock, which will make an even bigger burden on the country. So that's something to keep an eye on. And I think I'm not sure everyone else is looking at it, but I definitely am.
I'm going to borrow language from you. The Bank of Canada has been keeping an eye on Canada's housing market, sensitive to what rate cycles do. What is that impact?
Well, the housing market's adjusting as you would expect, to these higher rates. In other words, prices are coming down a bit. We've had this really strange immigration issue up here in terms of a lot of immigration coming down. So we have an issue of supply. At the same time, we have an affordability issue. So I think the federal government could do a lot of things, right? The provincial government to try to get more supply in. And I think this immigration, I'm very pro-immigration. I think Canada has great prospects and should allow a lot of skilled immigration in, but uncontrolled immigration of the type we've almost seen in the last year or so, I think can be quite disruptive.
Just lastly, before we let you go, the impact to this next rate cycle on the US dollar and I guess consequently the loonie.
Yeah, I think the US dollar will broadly probably be in a bit of a decline here. The thing about the US dollar, the dollar's driven, FX is driven by a whole bunch of different factors. And so, and hence notoriously they go, could be currencies can go cheap and stay cheap for years and then do the reverse, right? So I think my best guess in the US dollar is probably a slight decline as the Fed would probably lead the cycle. But remember, currencies are relative. Look what's going on with the ECB. Probably Japan is a little off in this cycle here. They're going to be up a bit. So I think being long yen, against the dollar makes sense. I think the Canadian dollar at here at 135, probably, I think we'll see a little bit of weakness would be my best guess going forward. Again, a lot of it driven by interest rate cycle differentials, as well as growth being better down there than up here.